Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss chapter 4, subject SST for standard 5. The topic of the chapter, equatorial region. Equatorial region means the name indicates the area found near to the equator, and it's situated between 0 degree to 10 degree latitude to the north and the south of the equator. And in this picture, this region, equatorial region, in the green part, and some countries where the region covers and it is falls in this continent. In Asia, the countries are given Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, etc., some part of Sri Lanka in India. In Africa continent, the countries are Congo Basin, Ghana, Liberia, etc. South America, Amazon River Basin, Ecuador, Colombia, and Brazil. So these are the area where the equatorial region. In this part, the sun rays are vertical over the equator region. Therefore, the temperature are very high throughout the year, and it is the average temperature 30 degree centigrade. And every day it experiences rain between 3 and 4 p.m. throughout the year. So it is called 4 o'clock rainfall or the tropical thunderstorm. And therefore humidity is very high in this region. So this is the region of equatorial part, and these are the features. Now I'm going to discuss very important country of this area. The name of the country is Democratic Republic of Congo. The Democratic Republic of Congo is the third largest country of Africa. It was known as the Republic of Zaire between 1971 and 1997. It is located in the Central America. The country is surrounded by the 9 countries. What are the neighboring countries? Central African Republic and Sudan in the north part, Uganda, Rwanda, Tanzania in the east, Zambia, Angola in the south, at the Republic Congo to the northwest. And the equator passes through the northern part of the Democratic Republic of Congo. And this region is covered with thick forest. Some river basin also, major valleys and high plateaus, and some important ranges, mountain ranges are like Ruwenzori mountain ranges, coastal plain of beautiful river lakes in this country include Albert, Edward, Kivu, etc. The Congo River is the country's main drainage system. This river rises in the Katanga Plateau and flows north and then south in the Great Arc, crossing the equator twice. River Kasai, Sangha, Ubangi, some are rivers names are given here, very important rivers of this country. Now I'm going to discuss the climate. This country falls in the equatorial part, so the Congo has the humid and tropical and equatorial climates are found. The temperature and humidity are very high and it rains throughout the year. However, the country receives maximum rainfall in the March and April. And this is very unfavorable condition for the people. The damp heat and daily rainfall causes lethargy. The condition also led to several diseases like malaria, yellow fever, and sleeping sickness. Now, vegetation and wildlife. It is very thick forest area, and we found very great variety of trees. The forests are very dense, and the trees grow into a tremendous height to 40 to 50 meters. And the trees form a thick canopy which prevents sunlight from reaching the forest floor. And the whole region is always dark, damp, and gloomy. Some variety of trees like mahogany, ebony, rimba, wenje, agba, some type of trees are found in this area. Some fiber plants include raffia and the sisal and cinchona. This is the source of quinine are used to prepare medicine. Rubber and the palm trees are also found. Some fruits like oranges, mangoes, guava, avocado, papaya and bananas also find. Talk about the animal, chimpanzees, African forest elephant, giant wild boars and short antelope are found in these areas, and gorilla live in the mountains. Lions, giraffe, hippopotamus, leopards and variety of snake inhabited in this grassland. Now okapi, it is a native to the Congo forest. It's just look like zebra and as well as a giraffe. An alligator, crocodile and a variety of fishes and dolphins are found in this river. Reptile like include various snakes such as python, viper, etc. found in this area. So students, this is the first part of the video of this chapter, and the next part of the video I will discuss the rest of the chapter. Till then, thank you.